What are agents? Agent is an internal background process operating the server on a periodic basis. Okay, so you see these agents in the sysadmin rule category. Okay, you can see here agents. So agents are of two types. One is standard agent and next one is advanced agent. So what's the difference between standard agents and advanced agent means? Standard agents will queue the agents. Coming to the advanced agents, they are not queued. Whenever you write anything in the agent, so it will first be taken by the master agent and it will be queued into the items, and then you know, then it start executing. But coming to the advanced agents, there will be no queuing things, directly it will get, you know, executed. So when you write agents, we should write an activity for an agent. Without an activity, you cannot write agents. So let's open one of the agent which is given here, which is already predefined, and see what is this, how the agent looks like. So these are all the different types of, so in an agent, for one rule set, you can create only one agent rule. And inside that you can write any number of agent names. So if you expand this, you can see over here, you can see that there is a class, and you can also see that there is one thing called as activity. Okay, so that means, what did you understand? Agent is always associated with the what is that? Activity. Without activity, you may not write or you may not create an agent. Okay, so let me open another agent. Yeah, it is also same, similar to that. Yes, if you see this agent, this particular agent, Pega import export, revalidate and save. You can see in the advanced, there is something called as auto queue management. Okay, so whenever you see this auto queue management, that means this particular agent is a standard agent. Okay, whenever this option is selected, then you can say it as a standard agent. Okay, so this is a standard agent. And coming to this, this is not a standard agent. Okay, so yes, you can say it is recurring daily. Okay, and this is not a standard agent because you don't see this auto queue management inside it. Okay, so yeah, can you see here, standard mode is standard. So if I take this one and change this to standard, you can see advanced agent, you can see auto queue management. So you can select this or you can unselect this. If you select this, it would be a standard agent mode of type, of type standard agent. So what happens in standard agent? Your agents would be queued, and according to the item which is queued, it would be executed. But coming to the advanced agent, your master agent directly picks the activity which is there in the agents and it will run it. So these all things happened in what, in which version? Before 8 version we used to use these agents. From 8 version, what we are using is, instead of agents, we are using job schedulers and queue processors. Okay, so if you see here, this is recurring one. Okay, recurring means it would be multiple times. This agent will execute multiple times. How much times? If you see on the advanced tab, you can see daily, every day it is like daily at 1 p.m. it will start. Okay, so that's recurring every time, multiple times. You can see here periodic, whenever it is periodic, so 5 times. Okay, 5 times it should be, it's also recurring. So whenever you say a agent is recurring, so that can be replaced by a job scheduler, because job scheduler also runs on the background, but it's a recurring task. Okay, your job scheduler is a recurring task. Okay, and the job scheduler is an advanced agent. Okay, job scheduler is what? It's an advanced agent. And coming to the queue processor replaces the standard agent that also runs in the background, right? But how this happens, how the the interaction happens between the between the Pega application and the agent, and what in the background, how it would be done is, in between there would be one protocol, one messaging protocol, which we call as Kafka data. Okay, so your messages will be into that this Kafka. So from Kafka, so Kafka is partitioned into 20 threads. Okay, and the message is in your Kafka, you have a topic, in topic you have 20 partitions, so 20 messages would be queued into it. So queue management will take that. So in this way you are improving the scalability of the scalability of your queue process. And even you can add multiple nodes. Okay, multiple nodes where you can use multiple nodes and use your queue processor to work on. So now we learn about queue processor. So as I said, you right, so you have a cluster of nodes you have. So one can be a background, one can be a search, one can be custom, one custom two. So there are some 15 nodes types we have, so it can be any of them. So it's a set of servers is called as a cluster. So you can ask, what we can do is, in one node we can work on our application, in another node what are the background processing you want to do, you can make it on that, so that there is a little weightage on one server. We are equally distributing the work to other servers so that there is no weightage on ours, no load on the servers. Okay, that you can do it. So coming to the queue process, as I said, you right, these are the replacements of standard agents. You can use standard queue process for simple queue management, or dedicated queue process for customized or delayed processing of messages. So again, you have two types of queue processings. One is dedicated, and another one is a simple immediate one. Okay, if you want to use the simple queue process, then directly you can use the standard queue process. Or if you want to you want to customize your queue process, then you can go for dedicated queue process. Okay, even in dedicated queue process, you can delay the queue process also. But there is no need of queue process to be executed immediately. You can make it as a delay, like you'll be doing an SLA, right? Immediate SLA, or SLA can be happened after 1 hour. Delay, time delay. You have this option. Right? Same thing in queue process also, you have it. Okay, so this is high scaling throughputs, because each queue processor can process message across 20 partitions. As I said, you right, it will work on your Kafka data. So where in the Kafka data it will create some 20 partitions. That means it will work on 20 separate threads simultaneously without any issues or without any conflicts. So then how do you execute, or how do you use this queue? Queue processors are always with respect to the work object, because I said you right, standard agents, these are replacements of standard agents. So standard agents are always dependent on your work object. Okay, so the queue processor also should be configured so that it will execute along with your cases, work objects, right? So then how do you configure this? Means using queue for processing method, which is available in activity, or run in background smart ship, which is there in your case lives or in your flow room. Okay, so you can use this here and there. And coming to the, when do you can manage or create your queue processor, means if the user is having these two privileges, then only he can create or manage the queue process. Okay, so as I said, you right, scaling, it can be vertical scaling by adding number of threads, or horizontal scaling by adding number of nodes. So this happens. This is why we say that there is more scalability in the queue process. Okay, as I said, there are two types of queue process, standard and as well as dedicated. You can even add a locking option when it is standard, means with respect to the access group you can do it using standard queue processor, and a dedicated queue processor you can delay it. okay, or you can even customize your queue process. If you are able to customize, then you go for dedicated queue process. So how your queue process looks like. So this is how your queue process looks like. So there is a queue processor, enable queue processor. So if you enable this, then this will execute. This will start run in the background. If you disable this, this will never execute in the background. And in the associated with node type, you can select one node here, any one of the nodes. So it can be background process, or it can be, I said, unit search. It can be anything. And when do you want to process? Whether you want to process immediate or delayed, or you want to delay it, you can go for delayed. Or you want to process it directly, then you can go for immediate. So in two ways you can process it. Coming to the number of threads, as I said, you right, it can work on 20 partitions or 20 threads, right? So it can be any number. Default is always one. You can make it 5, 6, or 10. It's up to you, but not more than 20. Even though you give 25, 30, 40 also, it takes only 20. And coming to the processing activity, as I said, you right, when you want to write a background processing, definitely you need an activity. So this class, to which activity in which class your activity is available, so that class you have to write over here. Okay, not only that, you have some other things also, like processing retries and alert configuration. So you have something called as max attempt is, if first time it your queue processor got failed, then it will check for another time. Like that, it will attempt three times. Okay, and initial delay 1 minute means when it starts, so it gives a pause of 1 minute and then it retries. After retry was unsuccessful, again it waits for 1 minute, again it retries. So like that, it will delay for each minute, and it will be multiplied by your delay factor. So whatever you write here, 2.0, right? So first it will multiply with 1 into 2.0 1, then 2.0 into 2, 4.0, then 4.0 into 2, like 8. So it multiplies. This is a multiplication. So how much time it should wait? First time it will wait for 1 minute. Second time it multiplies with this delay factor. Third time, already again the value which was given into the delay factor. So it will be like that. And alert configuration. So definitely your queue processor will send you an alert if it is not working. Okay. Means, or it is taking a lot of time to complete the task. So that is Pega 0011 alert which sends. You can see this in logs. Okay, whenever you are 1 second. So whenever your work is not your queue process is taking too much time, so it throws this particular alert. So it depends. If your activity is taking too much time, you can change this 1000 to some 12,000 milliseconds. It's up to you. Okay, this is actually a 1 second. So if you want to add more, 5, 6 seconds more, then you can increase the alert configuration also. Okay, that number. Coming to the differences between job scheduler and queue processor, as I didn't mention about what is job scheduler, I will come back to this slide again. Okay, so let's see how actually how your queue processor works. And before that, if queue processor has an issue, then what happens is it will add your queue processor into the broken item, this particular class system-message. An instance will be created under this. And if you have created a delayed queue processor, then that would be available under this particular class. An instance will be created under this particular class. Okay, one will be broken item where your queue processor failed, and one would be delayed item where your delayed queue process would be residing. Those instances would be residing over there. So let's jump into the thing, right? Yes. So how to create a queue processor? Okay, how to create queue processor? Queue processor is available under sysadmin itself. So right click, create queue processor. Yeah, queue processor is the replacement of what? Standard agent. And it will not occur multiple times, only one time. So I want to send
So I'm taking the same thing, and same thing is, since I'll go with this example, send email example, where my queue processor will send an email. Okay, so what is my requirement is, after sending an email, I will not ask feedback, just after getting the delivering the product. I want this to be done after 2 days. Okay, that's my requirement, after 2 days. So I can write a wait shape over here, or I can go with the background process. What is that? Background process, queue processor, where it will send an email. Okay, an email to the customer to give the feedback. So how do I do that? So I want to add what? I have to add run in background smart shape. So action automation. See, I can do both the ways. I can make my case to wait for 2 days and then send an email. So for that, I have to do, I have to write two things, one wait shape and then send email smart shape. Instead of doing that, what I'm doing is, I am sending a message. I'm sending a mail running background. I'm using the queue processor here. Queue processor, where I will write the queue processor one. So which is dedicated one, not standard. I'll go with dedicated one. So dedicated queue processor. So I've created one queue processor, right? So I'll use that. I created one send email queue processor. Okay. Can you see associated with the node type? It can have any one of them here. So I'll go with background processing. So whether it is immediate or delayed, I want to delay it for 2 days. So that's why I'm going with delayed. If I write immediately it will go, but I want to do it for delayed. So 2 days I want to make it delay. Okay, so number of threads, I can go with anything. So 5 minutes, it will create 5 threads. The class, so to which class it is? It's a purchase order, so I'll take purchase order. So for this I have to write one activity. So let me write an activity, feedback reminder. So I'm just creating one feedback reminder over here. Okay, so I didn't create an activity, so let me create an activity, feedback reminder, create and open. I'll use already OTP activity, which is there, send simple email. So let me use that, send simple email. So it has certain activity parameters, so add those parameters to whom you want to send. So I want to send it to this email, so let me write this email. Subject, I'll write it as reminder. Message, please provide feedback. So that I'm writing message. Even you can write correspondence also, but I'm not writing any correspondence. I'm just writing only just message, saying that please provide feedback. If I want to write more extra, if I have a lot of too much sentences or content, then I'll go with corner. So I don't have it, I just go with this. Okay, so view. You know about this, right? Activities. So I want this to be created only. So yeah, check out. So I created this activity. So now coming back to the queue processor, see, three attempts it is, one, two factor, and it is 2 seconds. Fine, it's all good. Let me save this. So yeah, okay, so when I save, so previously we used to, till 8.2, we used to create asynchronous processor request or type, but now from 8.4 onwards, it's not necessary. you can just simply configure in system runtime context. What is the system runtime context means? Make sure your application is available, your application rules, application is available under this system runtime context. If it is available, then automatically queue processor will be working. So what is your send email? What is it? It is department store. So I think it would be there, department store. Yes, I have that department store. Okay, so definition. Yes, we got online store 111 and department store also we'll have. Okay. 111 only. Right. Yes, so no worries with our system runtime context. So we run. So how do you check whether it is working or not? First, we need to configure this queue processor, right? So where do you configure? You configure it in your, I configured that under my case type only. So this is here. So what is a queue processor? So it is dedicated because I delayed it. I'm customizing one queue processor. So that is my process and delay. So what is the time? So you need to write a property here, one property, how much time you want to wait. So it is for 2 days, right? So you need to write that. So after delivering the product, in delivering the product, what we do is we'll write one field. Feedback date. Okay. So it should be date and time property only. So here only I'll write. So till that day, till then it will wait. Okay. So it can be 2 days, it can be 3 days, whatever the property, how much time you have mentioned, that time you have to add. Okay, dot feedback date. Okay, save. Okay, it's saved. So how do you check whether this is working or not? Means you need to go to admin studio. So in admin studio, you can see under resources queue processor. Okay, or you can see here 17 queue processor. So click me on queue processor. Anything is fine. Check here send email is there or not. Can you see send email is there? Is it running? No, it's not running. So let's start. So it's not started. So what could be the reason? I need to check whether yes, can you see stream service is not available, hence unable to collect Kafka data for this. So it is saying that it's not available. That's why it's unable to collect the Kafka data, because queue processor will be there in stream only, right? So stream service is down. So what I should do is I have to close it. Actually, I have to close this. Yeah, it's working now. I mean, it's working. It started. So let me add nothing. Okay, so once you log in, so it will be there in your admin studio also, it would be there. Okay. Yeah, so we didn't run our case type yet, so it's there in that. Can you see we have created run in background smart chip, we added that where we added this delayed queue processor. See here, so this should be on top of this. Before feedback only, I want to give this run in background. say. Yes. Let us go back to admin studio. There are 17 queue process. Ours is here, so it didn't start yet. We can start it. Okay. Yeah, we can start as this. So now if you want to do tracing, click on these three dots where you can do tracing over here. Okay, but as it is, it didn't start, that's why you cannot do any tracing. So tracing is disabled there. So let me first run this case. Okay, save, run this case. I'll directly jump into the order delivery. I don't want to see all those stages, so I'll directly jump into the last stage because I have a change stage option or optional action under actions, change stage. Choose stage, which one, delivery, order delivery, submit. So I directly jump into that. So submit, and here I have a time, feedback time. This is what I gave in the queue process, right? So yeah, so 11:44 it is, so I'll make it as 46. It's after 2 minutes it should start, that queue process should execute. Can you see it went to feedback, but in the background we are sending an email to that guy to please complete the feedback. So within 2 minutes we said, right? So let me go to admin studio and check whether it is started creating or not. Okay, so refresh. Can you see here scheduled? Can you see one is scheduled here? So scheduling is started. Which one? You can see this is the class. Okay, so this one, at what time enqueued? At 11:44, and it should be at 11:40. This is not our timings, Indian timings, it is EST. So you can see that. Okay, yeah, so let me trace it. So let me trace, how to trace. So I have to see here you have something like this and click on trace. So once it starts, you know, that send email queue processor gets started, right? So that time this would be tracing should be shown on your screen. Okay, so we are waiting for the tracer to complete or to get executed, and the queue process to be executed, which is, which will be, events would be captured in your tracer. Yes, started. See, it got executed. Your tracer, you know, that particular thing has been executed. And you see, call, send a simple email, got. See, whenever your queue processor starts executing, it would be created under a page called as PYQ page. Your details would be, queue processor details would be there under PYQ page. This is also important. Okay, so in your, you can see all the details under PYQ page name. So yes, so what are the things? So your case ID, okay, na? So all these things you can see. Okay, so right, it got executed means, yes, so it got executed, finished. Okay, so let's see whether leave, whether this got executed or not. You can see action, refresh. Can you see processed in last hour, send email? Yes, it got processed. Okay, see in view data flow, it will show you whether it has been added or not. So these are all previous ones. These are all previous ones where it was failed to prepare partition. That's why what we did is we what we said, we have closed our shut down our Pega server and restarted it. Okay, and you can see over here that there was a successful record. So unsuccessfully we have sent one message. So let's see whether message has, can you see reminder here, please provide feedback. Okay, mail has been sent. So this is how it will send an email to the respective email ID, right? Any doubts? For example, it fails. So we made it as delayed, right? We made it as delayed. So when it executed, we made it for 2 minutes delay, right? So again, I'll create another case, another, sorry, what is that? So let me open this data. Okay, I'll see this. So let me create another case. Purchase order. Okay, submit, create. Let me directly jump into the last stage. So you want to wait for 5 minutes. Okay, 11:50 it is. So I'll select the same thing. I'll make it as 11:55. So your queue processor got started, but it has been delayed, right? It is in delay. So how do you know whether it is in delayed or not? So let me open from admin studio and see whether processing has happened or not. So we made 5 minutes, right? Can you see here? One is there, 5 minutes. So let me open. So this is the QID. Okay, this is a QID. We'll open the data model also. This is in view. Okay, this is QID guy, QID, okay. So we see whether the same QID is there or not in our dev studio. Okay, so it is waiting for 5 minutes. Actually, it is waiting for how many minutes? 5 minutes. So let me go back there. So how do you know that QID is there? Means I said you, right, it will be available under delayed system message queue processor under delayed. So let's click on this. Can you see? Is it same or not? I copied that. Can you see? This and this are same. So it is in delayed item. So it waits for that. Until 5 minutes, it will wait and checks. Okay. Until 5 minutes, it wait. And once it is completed, this email, this in your broken item, this particular queue item would be removed because it has been successful. And you can see all the broken items under this one. Okay, if something is broken, it will be showing on the screen. Okay, if that means if your queue processor is not working, it's failed, then you can see over here the relay write-up, you can see here. So till 5 minutes it would be here. So click refresh. So I think still 5 minutes have not completed. No, it's just another 1 minute we have to wait. So after that, it goes out of from the this particular delayed item. Gone means it executed successfully. Got it? So it got successfully executed. So this is how queue processor works in the background.